Okay, so if you're using Microsoft Excel and you want to record your employees' time, I'm going to show you a pretty easy way to do it. So this sheet has been set up with something called data validation, and I'll show you how I did that. So if you highlight the column that you're going to have the dates go into and go to the data ribbon, left-click on data validation and set up a rule that you're only going to allow a date, and then Excel also wants a range for the dates. So do it between, and I just picked today. And then for the end date, I picked the date pretty far out just so you don't have to redo this. And what this will do, whenever your user comes in, if they don't put in a valid date, it's going to give them an error alert. So we're gonna look at that. But before we do, look at input message. I took this off because if you have an input message, it's going to be popping up every time you use the sheet. But after the first time or two, you're gonna know. So I don't think you needed that. But I did put in an error alert, so I checked the box here. It's going to show you this red X, and it's going to tell you to enter a valid date if the date's not right. Go ahead and click OK. I'm going to go to a cell, let's say D8, and I'm going to enter something that's not a valid date. So let's just say June 1st, 2018. Excel's not going to like this because of the 1SD. If you just said June 1, it would recognize it. But if I hit enter, I'm going to get that warning sign. If you do retry and you do 6, we can even use dashes, 6-1-18. That's going to be valid. It'll recognize it. A similar thing was done with the time column. So if I highlight this and I go up to data validation, I said it has to be a time. And it has to be in between midnight and midnight. And there's going to be, again, no input message because I don't think you want to see that every single time. And if it doesn't do a valid time, it's going to give you the red X again and tell you, enter a valid time. So if I click OK here, what this is going to prevent is 2 p.m., say without a space. Excel wants a space in between the 2 and the p.m. Won't let you do it. So let's retry. Let's do it as 14 military time. Says no. But if you do 14:00, enter, that's okay with it. Or if you do 2:00 space PM, that's okay as well. So there's only so many ways to enter a valid date in a valid time in Excel. And if you don't get at least as far as that point, no matter what timesheet you use, it's not going to work. So with these two data validations, we've gotten to the point where we have valid inputs. And this timesheet can also do overnight shifts. So this person clocked in at 6:01:18. They're going to clock out at 6:02:18. And it's going to be at 3:02 in the morning, a.m. And that's a 13-hour shift. So I'll show you the formula that we're using in column E. I'll go into cell E9, double click. And what this is doing is this is adding together row 9 to get June 2nd, 3:02 a.m. So that's C9 plus D9. And then it's subtracting the value of June 1st, 2 p.m. added together. And the result of these two being subtracted from each other is then multiplied by 24 because it comes out as a fraction of a day. So if you want to convert it from a fraction of a day to hours, multiply it by 24. And there's your result, 13.03 hours. If the employee clocks in and out, you just add another line. And you can add as many lines to this as you want, right? There's no limitation. I just made it small so that you could see it easily. And at the bottom, just use a sum formula to sum the column. And this are the hours right there that you can pay your employee. So I hope that was helpful. And if you like this tutorial, I have a lot of others just like it. If you can subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.